Hello everyone. Okay, today I want to show you the Samsung Galaxy Note 2 and near-field communication. So NFC, as it's more commonly known, are small chips that can be embedded into objects, and your device can then read the information contained on that chip. Now, the chips are actually quite small, and they only hold a very small amount of data. For instance, this pen holds 136 bytes of information. Now, if I take this pen and I pass it down the back of the Samsung Galaxy Note 2, as soon as it passes over the reader, it pulls the information directly from the chip and does the action. In this case, loading the website. But you can store all sorts of different information onto these, including contact information like phone numbers, addresses. You could put your special offers. You could also do special commands that, depending on the software running on the device, will allow it to fire up a check-in for Foursquare, for instance, or load a flyer or an offer. All sorts of different things. But also, from like a personal point of view, around your home, within your own life, you can program NFC chips to do actions for you. So if you have an application on your phone like Tasker, and another application like NFC Task, you can use those applications to, say for instance, set up one of these NFC tags to turn your Wi-Fi on and off. So as you're going out for the day, swipe over the top of the tag, your Wi-Fi is turned off, saving your battery life while you're out. For instance, you could also use it to dim your screen and put your phone onto silent at night. Instead of having to faff around with all of the settings, all you need to do is just swipe and it's done. So let's have a quick look at actually how you write data onto these. Now, my preferred app is TagWriter. Now, the reason for that is if you go into the settings on TagWriter, or preferences in this case, and if you come down to, let's have a look where it's gone. There's an option basically in here which allows you to switch UE mode. Turn it, take it off Light Edition, put it onto Professional Edition, and you gain a load of extra features. For instance, under Create and Write, when you go to create a new tag, you have a lot more options, including mail, telephone numbers, a Bluetooth hit, geolocation, file URI, or URI. I have found it's more compatible when you're trying to do things with website addresses or update a curl command or something like that. Use URI. Works much more successfully than trying to use something like a bookmark. Much better to work with that particular option. But all we need to do, go into URI, we'll give it a name, give it a website. Oops. Google.com. Next. Now at this point, all we need to do is hit next. Now you've got a couple of options here. You can write multiple, so you can keep stacking tags underneath one after another, keep writing. You can protect the tag, or you can confirm if there's already data on the tag and you know, don't want to overwrite it. Just in case you happen to use a tag that's already got useful data on there, you've got that option. Or you can protect the tag to stop it from being rewritten to later. Go to next, and all we need to do then is just pop the tag underneath and just wait a few seconds. And we get a chime, and that tells us tag is done. Click done. Right, that should be our tag. So now if I pass this back under, fires Google. Simple as that.